Thank you. We're here tonight to honour the memory and remember the great Bix Beiderbecke and all those wonderful musicians he played with. And Bix, of course, was born on the 10th of March 1903 in Iowa, in the United States, in Davenport, Iowa, and started playing cornet with a band called the Wolverines. That was a number from their first recording date in 1924, Tijuana. Right now we're moving on to a number which Bix recorded with Frankie Trumbar's orchestra, the great sing melody saxophonist who was with Bix most of his playing life. And it's a tune called Ostrich Walk. Two of my members have gone to Sacramento Jazz Festival with the Zenith Hot Stompers. But taking their place, we have two wonderful musicians and an extra surprise guest with us tonight. And I'll introduce them right now. I'm the trombone taking a rest from the Cotton Club Orchestra, his orchestra, Keith Nichols. Tonight on trombone. And from the Harmony Hounds, two great musicians. I'm so pleased to have them playing with me. On guitar, Chris Howes. And banjo and vocal, as you'll be hearing all the time. And on the bass saxophone, the wonderful Colin Turner. And my regular members, of course, on the clarinet and saxophone, and also vocal, a little later on, Norman Field. Piano, Jon Penn. And strikingly handsome, 6'5", drummer man, the youngest of the group, Nick Ward. And of course, and I'm Gordon Whitworth, as you know. Right, here we go then. This is a great song that Bix recorded with Paul Whiteman's orchestra and with his own small group, Bix and His Gang, which of course contained many members of the larger orchestra, split into a small group for recording sessions. And it's a tune called Louisiana. And on the Whiteman record, of course, it was Bing Crosby, a young Bing Crosby, who sang the vocal on one of their recordings. Chris Howse is going to step forward and sing that one for us.
Thank you.
Well, this is next number is coming up. It's a great number that Bix recorded with him. It contains a wonderful cornet solo, which has been the thing for all cornets to try to copy, but never quite made it. But I'm going to have a go tonight. And at this wonderful number, and of course, there's a great C melody saxophone solo by Frank Trumbar. It was Frank Trumbar's orchestra in 1927 recorded this number. And Norman Field's going to take the Frankie Trumbar classic solo on Singing the Blues.
Thank you.
is called Rhythm King.
Thank you.
several words that was, Keith. I don't know much about reading music, except these later years with Whiteman and Goldkett, and always struggled then. But what a jazzman, what a cornet player, and what a piano player. Bix played piano, teaching himself at an early age, at 5 years of age, playing, lifting himself up and tapping out melodies, and he recorded some great, a few piano solos later in life, and the most famous of all was In a Mist, written and played by Bix Beiderbecke in 1927. Jon Penn is going to play In a Mist.
Sorry.
We're going to go out for that interval number with a number recorded by Paul Whiteman with young Bing Crosby doing the vocal. Norman Field's going to sing on this one. It's called From Monday On.
Let's go!
cut our way now to a number which Bix recorded with the Paul Whiteman Band Orchestra. And of course, on that one, the vocalist was Bing Crosby, young Bing Crosby, who was a member of the three-man vocal group, the Rhythm Boys. And it's called Oh Miss Hannah, Ain't You Coming Out Tonight?
composer credits is Quicksell and Quicksell. So the implication either is that there are two people, like, you know, he wrote it with his brother or his cousin, or else the typographer on the record label made a mistake. But back in 1987, they recorded this tune, and they used the double tempo thing, which is the harmony tempo, which goes something like this.
Thank you. Thank you. calling your name. Here am I with all my bruises blur. Just a baby under your concern. Lock the doors, I'll be yours. Cause you took advantage of me.
Just as far as you like with me in my merry Oldsmobile. Fast number, and so we thought to give the boys a little chance to get a beer and just to cool things down, we're going to do it as a duet. It's a lovely melody nevertheless, and it's called Davenport Blues. so proud to have a band like this. In fact, as I said early on in the evening, we have three different faces in the lineup tonight. Two of our men are in Sacramento at the Dixieland Jubilee Festival, and with the Zenith Hot Stompers, and we're very pleased to have on trombone Mr. Keith Nichols. And on the guitar and banjo and vocals, Chris Howse. And the wonderful baritone saxophonist. Bass. What am I talking about? Colin Turner. Also from Harmony Hands. My regular boys are, of course, Jon Penn on the piano. The great Nick Ward on drums. And the one and only Norman Field on saxophone.
And doing a splendid job holding it all together and also interpreting the very demanding Bix Beiderbecke part, ladies and gentlemen, Gordon Whitworth.
For him, I'll be a friend with pleasure. I'll let Norman Field tell you all about this.
Briefly, you see, by 1930, when Bix had this session under his own name, the hot jazz of the 20s was going out of fashion. There'd been the Wall Street crash, people didn't want that kind of hot, you know, syncopated hot jazz stuff anymore. They wanted nice sentimental numbers, and they didn't have the money to buy records. So Bix had this band which he took into the studio, and they mostly recorded slow, sentimental numbers. And of course, since it was virtually his last recording session, it's a bit sad when you play it, and especially on a sort of gloomy Sunday afternoon in February, I really don't think we ought to play this. But happily, it's actually a nice evening in May in Keswick. It may well be raining, but it's well, yes, I know. But at least our version of it doesn't have all the crackling on it that my HMV does. So we'll do this rather sad song for you. I'll be a friend with pleasure.
Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. I'll own up to that. I'll own up to the fault there. No one's infallible. We'll start again.
Sorry about that, chaps. I eat my rock out.
Sad note, it is rather sad, it was one of Bix's last recordings, so we're going out with a number which he recorded with Frankie Trumbar's orchestra and a real cracker called Clarinet Marmalade.